Hi guys, so today I want to make with your roasted Chilean sea bass with miso clam sauce and black rice. Chilean sea bass, I love the fish. Whenever I go out to the restaurants and I see it on the menu, I always get it. I love trying it at different locations. It is one of my favorite fishes, so that's why I want to make it with you today. So let's begin with the rice, because it's going to take the longest. I'm going to wash the rice. I'm gonna add water and cook your rice according to the instructions on the back of the package. And we'll go from there. All right guys, I got the rice cooking and I turned our oven up to 425. What we're gonna do is we're gonna skin the pieces of fish, just like so. I'm gonna go right underneath the skin, okay? And I'm going to take this beautiful piece right here. That's one. Okay, second one. Right underneath. All right, another one. All right, guys, so I'm going to put a little bit of oil, just like that, on my fingers. Put the skins on the tray. I season them lightly with salt and pepper. I'm going to put another silicone sheet right over it. And a sheet pan to keep it flat. You guys can use parchment paper or foil, whatever you choose. I'm gonna pop it in my oven. Oven is hot. Set that in there. We'll check on it as needed. And we got these two pieces, and we're feeding four people. So we're looking at about 5 ounce pieces each. So I'm just gonna cut it right here, like so. And I checked it for bones already, so we're okay, there's no bones. I pulled a lot of them out. You should do the same. So we got four pieces like that. Okay guys, so I'm gonna transfer my fish on this plate and take it over to my pan. All right, my pan is nice and hot. I've had it heating. I'm just turning up a little more. Right, oil goes in, nice and hot. And the fish, I'm gonna find a presentation side for the fish. In my case, I want this one right here. I'm gonna just lay it down like so. Another piece. One more. And one here. I got my spatula. So once the fish is ready to release from the pan, I will know, because you'll release with almost no effort. Just by me testing it with the spatula, I know it's not ready yet. We're searing it on one side. Okay guys, the fish been cooking for about 3 minutes, and I'm gonna check if it's ready to release. Okay, it feels pretty good. I think it's ready to come off. Okay. Alright, our first piece, beautiful, piece number four. Alright, nice. Okay guys, so the fish is seared on one side, okay? So let's begin with our clam and miso base sauce. Alright, so I got a pound of clams here, beautiful clams. As you see, they're opening up and the bubbles are coming out. That means they're opening up and letting all those particles that are trapped in them, the sand and stuff and the dirt, out into the water. So what I did, I just scrubbed them really, really well a few times, and then I put them in this pot and poured water, and I seasoned the water with a good amount of salt to resemble an ocean. So they think they're in their own environment and they keep on opening up and closing, and all that stuff that's inside them comes out, and that's how they get clean. Okay, so I'm gonna just set them aside here, and you would wanna give them at least an hour or two in nice cold water, and that'll be the best. It'll be nice and clean. Okay, I'm gonna put my ginger and shallot into the hot pan, just like that. It doesn't matter, it doesn't have to be perfect. You don't have to slice it in any way, just get them in there, small enough like that. Celery can go in, and green onions, scallions go in, okay? Star anise, two of those. Some black peppercorns can go in. Start mixing. Okay. good. Miso. All right, at this point, we can add some cream. And our cilantro. I'm gonna reduce it a little bit. All right, I'm gonna control the sauce with a little bit of warm water, just so we get all the flavor from the vegetables, infusing our nice white sauce. Okay, let it boil for a little bit. Okay, so this is our sauce here. All right, all the vegetables and the spices have infused it so far. Okay, I'll add a little bit of water just so we can strain it a little easier. Okay, like so. You can turn the heat off for now. And that goes in there. Okay. Wash the pan out with the same water to get all the flavors out. Okay. Okay guys, so squeeze as much of that beautiful juice that you have just made, that sauce, out of your veggies, just like that. Okay, and this stuff you can just get rid of, right? You can no longer need it. That's it, the sauce is set up. Clams are getting clean. All right, so it's been about 20 minutes since we put that skin in the oven. Let's check on it. All right. Okay, beautiful. Nice and crispy. All right, put them on a plate here. Just like that. Let's set our asparagus up. Okay. Just really basic, little oil, little butter, pepper. Okay. Work that oil in there, the seasonings. Lay it out. Okay, the butter will melt right into it. Okay, so now we can set our fish. Can go right on the same tray, right next to the asparagus, like that. And as you see, I have some of that beautiful fish juice that can go into the sauce. Okay, don't waste any of those beautiful flavors. All right, so now it's time to cook our clams. We're just gonna put some oil, a little bit of that butter right in there. Okay, it's time to cook our clams. I got the oil nice and hot. And I'm gonna add the clams in really quick and close it with the lid so they don't splash all over. Like that. Okay. All right. So we're gonna just let them cook in that oil for a few minutes, okay? Once they're gonna start opening up, we'll add the cream in there. Okay. And as you see, it starts to happen fairly quick. You see? So if you will find, once you're done with the sauce and everything, if you find a clam that did not open, make sure you discard it. Do not eat it. It was dead prior to you cooking it. You don't want to eat that. You will get sick. So stay away from those. Okay, our clams are starting to open. Okay, as you see, they're cooking in their own juices. And we're gonna just turn the heat off for now. Okay. Okay guys, so the sauce is done. The clams all opened up, beautiful. And I added the seaweed in there. Again, that's optional, but if you want that little ocean flavor, that little touch, that does boost the flavor up, okay? So I'm gonna just set the sauce on a side over here. It'll stay warm. The rice is almost done. So let's get our fish in the oven. The oven is still at 425. I'm gonna just pop the asparagus and the fish in there and we'll check on that. All right, and we'll be back with you guys when we're ready to check on the fish, all right? All right, so let's check on our fish and our asparagus. Okay, so, wow, it's perfect. I can touch it, I can feel it, that it's done. You guys can use your thermometer. Asparagus, that's where I want it, that bright green color. If you overcook it, you'll lose that brightness. Okay, the clams are ready, the sauce is ready, the rice, all right, ready for us. I'm just waiting on the plates to be hot, and we're ready to start plating. All right, okay, it's time to start plating. We got a beautiful black rice. It's gonna go right into these molds. Okay. The fish can go right on top. Three pieces, will do. So time for the skins to go in. Just gonna stick it right into the rice, like so. All right, so this is just for a little extra touch. All right, some black truffles from Italy. All right, there's like little chips, they're little bites. Put a few here, a few on this one. Okay, so guys, that's the dish. It took about an hour to prepare, and it's time for the taste test. Let's see how it came out. All right, guys, so it's dinner time for us, and we're ready to dig in and see how our dish came out. All right, so let's begin.
Oh my God.
No wonder this is one of my big favorite fishes. I mean, Chilean sea bass, cannot go wrong with that fish. Whenever you see it on the menu in a restaurant, guys, get it. You will not be disappointed. I mean, the fish has, it's like a really meaty piece of meat that you're eating. It's white, doesn't have any fish flavors or anything. I mean, it is really amazing. Chilean sea bass, it's really good.
No joke, this is amazing. With the cream and the rice, wow.
Right? I mean, we feel like we're in a really expensive restaurant right now, I'll tell you that. It is really, really good. All right, guys, so you have anything to say, Dennis?
Listen, guys, make sure to like and subscribe. If you enjoyed the videos, hit the bell notification. Also, if you guys would like to, you guys can follow us at vals.vlogs on Instagram. I'll put the link in the description, and I hope you guys enjoy it.